We'll start the class. So what we have discussed is chapter 3. So what we have completed is qualitative analysis. So what is qualitative analysis means? So yesterday we have discussed, let's say if you have A gives B, A gives C, if you have two reactors, or let's say CA power N1, K1, this is K2, CA power N2, if you have two reactions, then how to select a reactor is if N1 and desired, or let's say this is desired, this is undesired, N desired is greater than undesired, then you should select a PFR, N desired is less than N undesired, you should select a CSTR. Similarly, if you have A gives B gives C, if you want to maximum of, let's say B, then you should always select a PFR, because in CSTR, you do not have any guarantee over, let's say, the residence time of the reactor. Similarly, we have discussed, let's say, the temperature profiles also. If the activation energy, so overall, if the activation energy of desired is higher than undesired, you should go for, let's say, high temperature. Activation energy less than activation undesired, you should go for, let's say, low temperature. This is what we have discussed, let's say, in yesterday's class. So what is this is qualitative analysis. Qualitative analysis means only direction. So it doesn't tell you, let's say, exactly with respect to numbers. Qualitative analysis means, suppose if N greater than 0, you should select a PFR. N less than 0, you should select a CSTR. So this is called as qualitative analysis. But later on, we have proved with respect to problems, no? So when we solve the problems for a first order reaction, if I select, let's say, a CSTR, so I'm getting the higher, for first order reaction, I'm getting volume of PFR less than volume of CSTR. That is what we have proven, that is quantitative analysis. So what we do now is quantitative analysis. Quantitative analysis. So first we'll do the quantitative analysis for, let's say, parallel reactions. So what is problem here is, let's take A gives B, A gives C. Let's say this kinetics is, let's say, 0.1 CA square. This is, let's say, 2 CA. So this is the kinetics of the reaction. Clear? Suppose if I have, let's say, CA naught, which is 40 mole per liter. Clear? So, and then what is conversion of A is, let's say, 90%. Conversion of AB is 90%. Then what is CB and what is CC? Can you calculate with this information? So I am trying to explain this concept is, I will start with the problem, and in the problem I will try to analyze this concept. So can you calculate what are the answers here? So I will not mention anything here. So only thing is, I mentioned the reaction A gives B, A gives C, 0.1 CA square, 2 CA, CA naught is 40 mole per liter, XA is 90%, CB and CC. So here there is no concept of desired product, no? Because I am asking both. What is concentration of B and what is concentration of C, both. So my question is, first, can you solve with this information or not? So basically, you cannot solve this question with this information. Cannot solve this question with this information. So what is missing here is what you have is let's say CA naught, which is 40 mole per liter, and conversion is 90%. What does this mean is 36 moles per liter of A is converted. Clear? 36 mole of A is converted. Out of this 36 mole per liter, how much of A is converted to B? Similarly, how much of A is converted to C? So how much of A is converted to B and how much of A is converted to C? So we have, let's say, simple 36 moles of A which is converted. So overall 36 moles of A is converted, because A is going in this direction and A is going in this direction, both the directions it is going now. So out of the 36 moles of per liter of A, how much of A is converted to B and how much of A is converted to C? This information we don't know. So how to calculate this information? How to calculate this information? How do you calculate this information? Have you understood what is missing? I cannot solve with this information because I don't know these numbers. How much of A? Out of 36, how much of A is converted to B? Out of 36, how much of A is converted to C? We don't know. So any thoughts how to calculate this information? So how do we calculate that information is, I'll define, let's say, a concept called, let's say small phi. So let's say, just what is that information that we want is called as, what do you want basically? So I'll define a parameter which is phi, which is called as rate of B formation divided by rate of A. So what does this tell you is moles of B formed per, let's say, mole of A converted. This is what is we want, no? In the previous slide, what am I asking in the previous slide? In the previous slide, if you see, how much of A is converted to B? So basically, if 1 mole of A is converted, roughly, don't take 36. Out of, because if you take for 1 mole, if you know the distribution, somebody is asking yesterday, what is product distribution question? So this is what is called as product distribution. So if 1 mole of A is converted, how many moles of B is formed? So if 1 mole of A is converted, how many moles of C is formed? So that is what I have written. Rate of B formation divided by rate of A converted. What is rate of B formed is nothing but, let's say, 0.1 CA square. What is rate of, let's say, A converted? 0.1 CA square plus, let's say, 2 CA. So this we need to calculate. Where we need to calculate this one? Is it reactor inlet or outlet or, let's say, in the reactor? So where we need to calculate this number? So inlet or outlet or, let's say, inside the reactor. So inlet or outlet or, let's say, inside. Because this moles of deforming, moles of A converting, where is it happening? Inside the reactor, no? So you need to calculate this inside the reactor. Inside the reactor. Now, is this number same for CSTR or PFR? So this phi P, is it same for CSTR and PFR or is it different? Is it different or same? So this phi B is basically a function of concentration of A, which is different for CSTR and PFR. Why it is different for CSTR PFR? Because it is a function of concentration. No, this is a function of concentration. So CSTR has a different average concentration, PFR has a different average concentration. So this phi B is a function of concentration of A. So this is different for CSTR, this is different for PFR. So have you understood till now? This is slightly tough topic in the entire CRE, or let's say CRE 1. Quantitative analysis of parallel reactions is slightly tough topic. So what I need to calculate is per mole of A converted, how many moles of B formed? So per mole of A converted, how many moles of B formed I need to calculate. So for that one, what is rate of B formation is 0.1 Ca square. Rate of A formation is 0.1 Ca square plus 2 Ca, because which is given in the reactions. This number I need to calculate inside the reactor. This number I need to calculate inside the reactor, because this both A conversion and B forming are happening inside the reactor. Clear? So this both A conversion and B formation are happening inside the reactor only. Now, when I want to calculate, let's say this inside the reactor, this number is different for CSTR, different. Suppose, let's imagine that this number is same for CSTR and PFR. Then, for every mole of A converted, the B formation is same in CSTR and PFR, no? Then it is contradicting with your quantitative analysis, no? So, in quantitative analysis, B formation should be favored by a CSTR, and PFR, C formation should be favored by a CSTR. So this is B formation is second order, C formation is first order. So B should be preferable in PFR, so C should be preferable in CSTR. But if this number is same for CSTR and PFR, 5B, then for every mole of A converted, the mole of B formation, which is same for CSTR, which is same for, let's say, PFR. So that should not be the case. So it should be different for CSTR and PFR, because imagine that CSTR and PFR has different concentrations. So this different concentrations will lead to different rate of reactions. So that means this different rate of reactions of B, rate of reactions of C. So that will lead to, let's say, different product distribution for CSTR, different product distribution for, let's say, PFR. Everybody understood up to now? So I'm giving some time in between so that you will digest the concept. If you just understood, say yes in the chat so that I'll come to know, let's say, how many people are clear or let's say not clear. If you are not clear till now, I explained two times, I'll go ahead and solve the problems. I am going to solve three problems for this model, because this is slightly tough model. So I'm going to repeat three problems. I am sure 100% that by the third problem, everybody will understand. Yes, I am getting, let's say, most of the responses as yes. So somebody is asking to repeat once again. So I told you that I am going to explain this concept, let's say, 3-4 times right now. So what is my, let's say, now I have to take the reactor. I have to fix the reactor. That is why in the previous board, when you are solving, you cannot solve this question with this information, because this information is missing. But this information requires what is the type of reactor, because this, suppose if I take, let's say, now I'll take, let's say, CSTR. If I take CSTR, I'll calculate this number. So CSTR, what is the concentration here? CA, concentration is CA here. So what is Ca here is, which is equal to Ca, which is equal to Ca naught. Now what is this number 5B inside the reactor? Will it be same or different? At every volume of the reactor, the value of 5B will be same because the concentration is same across the reactor. So my average 5B across, or let's say my average 5B inside the reactor, average 5B is equal to 5B calculated with, let's say, exit conditions. Now when the variable is same throughout the reactor, what is the average? Which is nothing but average, which is nothing but the same value. No, what is here 5BF, what is concentration here? CAF, which is equal to CF. So what is my average 5B inside the reactor? Is 5B calculated with, let's say, exit conditions. So what is the exit conditions? What is your CAF concentration? What is my inlet is 40, conversion is, let's say, 1 minus 0.9. So what is my exit concentration is 4. So then what is my average 5B average, which is equal to 0.1 CAF square divided by 0.1 CAF square plus 2 into CAF. What is 0.1 CAF square is 0.1 into 4 square divided by 0.1 into 4 square plus 2 into 4. This is what is 5B average. What is this value? So what is this value coming? 0.16. So what is my 5B average in a CSTR is 0.16. What is this meaning of 0.16? What is this meaning of 0.16? For every mole of A converted, 0.16 moles of B form. This is what you want, no? For every mole of A converted, 0.16 moles of B formed. Clear? This is something which I told in the first slide, that you cannot calculate this information because you don't have information. So overall, how many moles of A converted? How many moles of A converted is Ca naught minus CF? These many moles of A converted, no? How many moles of B formed? CBF minus CB naught. So this is overall how many moles of B formed. This is overall how many moles of A converted, which is equal to 0.16. Clear? So on an average, overall, Ca naught is A entered, CAF is A exited. These many moles of A converted. CBF is moles of B out. This is moles of B in. These many moles of B formed. So what is CB naught here? 0. Then what is the concentration of B at the exit? Is basically 0.16 into 40 minus 4. Or else, if you are, let's say, confused here, for every mole of A converted, 0.16 moles of B formed. So how many moles of A converted here? 36 moles of A converted. So how much amount of B formed in the reaction is 0.16 into 36. That is the same answer. No? Now you got, let's say, what is the concentration of B at the exit of CSTR? You have done this calculation for CSTR. Similarly, can you calculate what is CCF? CCF means what you should write? Rate of C formation divided by rate of A conversion. CB naught is 0 because it is given in the question that Ca naught is 40, there is no CB naught, no? feed is pure air. Let's spend some time on this question throughout the. I hope you are writing the running notes, everybody. So just stay on your notes and understand this again. So if 1 mole of A converted, so 0.16 moles of B formed. So 0.16 moles of B formed means how many moles of B converted, A converted is 0.16. So how many moles of A left is 0.84. So how many moles of C formed is also 0.84. You can calculate like this also. So simply for every mole of A converted, B formed is 0.16. So what is the rest is C. That is true if you have an equimolar reaction, something like this. Suppose if I give, let's say, reaction A gives 2B, let's say 5C. Then so you cannot, let's say it is little difficult, you can't do is not the question, you can do but it is little difficult. So that is why for 5CF also we will follow the same expression, which is rate of C formation divided by rate of A conversion, which is 2CA divided by 0.1 CA square plus 2CA. This is what does this 5C is, this is what is, this is what is product distribution. For every mole of A converted, how many moles of, let's say, C form? Clear? Now, this has to be calculated for CA. Now, this is different for CSTR. This is different for, let's say, PFR. So, what is for CSTR is nothing but phi of CS average is equal to phi C average is equal to 5CF is equal to 5CF. So what is 5CF is 2CF divided by 0.1 CF square into 2 into CF. What is 2CF? 2 into 4 divided by 0.1 into 4 square plus 2 into 4. So what is here? There is no surprise, you will get 0.84. Then next point. So after this one, so I'll write here. what is concentration of CCF minus CC naught divided by CA naught minus CAF is equal to 0.84. So what is this is 0. What is this value is 40 minus 4. What is CCF is 0.84 into 36. This is what is concentration of CCF. So somebody who has solved this one, can you try to solve this same for PFR? So in PFR, concentration is not same. Yes, somebody has written correctly. PFR is complicated. I think integration is required. Correct. Because plane wise, the concentration is different. So plane wise, the 5E is also different. So can somebody write on a rough paper and see how do you do it for a PFR? So PFR, we have to calculate 5B on each plane and we have to calculate average. That means we have to integrate 5B on each plane. Then we have to take the average. So can you try to write the expression? So I hope everybody has done for CSTR. Now we are doing it for PFR. So please listen carefully. PFR, the inlet concentration is CNO. The outlet concentration is CF. So let's take, you have, this is CA1. Let's assume that you have only four planes. Just for simplicity. In reality, you have infinity planes. What is 5B here? 5B will be different. 5B2, 5B3, 5B4. Why on every plane the concentration of A is different? So 5B is different. So what is my 5B average across the reactor is nothing but integral of CA0 to CAF 5B into DCA. Correct or not? What is this integral? Integral is sum or average? What is the meaning of integral? Does it give sum or average? Sum. So you have added 5B1 plus 5B2 plus 5B3 plus 5B4. So this is what it gives. That means it is only, integration is only sum. So how do you calculate average? How do you calculate average is divided by integral length, which is CA0 to CAF. CA naught minus CF, which is CA naught minus CF. So integral gives only the sum and this gives average. And here DCA is positive or negative? If you calculate this number, do you get positive number or negative number? Negative number, because DCA is negative. To make it positive, I'm putting another negative sign. So you got it here. So can you calculate average? 5B average, which is equal to minus 1 divided by what is CA naught? 40. Minus what is 4? This is 40 to 4. What is 5B? Is 0.1 CA square divided by 2DC. You have to solve this entire integral. Always you remember, so the concept is always direct. Now look at this equation. Look at this equation also, you can say it is a PFR because you are calculating 5B average. So you are calculating 5B average because the 5B is different on each plane. Why 5B is different? Because the concentration is different. Why the concentration is different? Because it is a PFR. So the mass will also tells the science of the question. Clear? So can you solve this integral and tell me what is 5B average? So why we have put minus sign? Because DCA is negative. This DCA is negative. So if I don't put minus sign, you will get this entire 5B average as negative. So to make it positive, I put this negative sign. Now what is 5B average? Now if you solve this integral, minus 1 by, which is 36 into 40 to 4, 2CA by CA, CA will cancel. What is left is 0.2. DC. How do you solve this equation? Plus 2, minus 2. So how do you solve this integral is 136. So integral 40 to 4. What do you get is this 0.1 CA. If you add it here, 1 minus 2 by 0.1 CA plus 2 U's into DCA, which is 2. Minus 1 by 36, which is equal to what is DCA? CA integral. Minus 2 by 0.1 into ln of 0.1 CA plus 2, which is equal to 40 to 4. CA square, but CA square will be cancelled, no? Denominator and numerator. So this is what is 5B average. What is the answer that you are getting here, 5B average? What is 5B average? It is nothing but CB naught minus CBF minus CB naught divided by CA naught minus CF, which is equal to whatever the answer that you got here. So what is 5B average? CBF minus CB naught divided by Ca naught minus Cf, which is equal to whatever the answer you got. What is Ca naught minus Cf? Here 36, no? Minus 1 by 36 into entire this x. 36, 36 will cancel. Cb naught is 0. So then what is Cbf is answer that you want. So what is the answer that you are getting, CBF? 17.67. So can you calculate CBF, CCF similarly? So why it has become 0.1 Ca square by 0.1 Ca square plus 2 Ca, no? I have cancelled for Ca on both sides. So if you go to previous board, so Ca square here, this and this will cancel, no? That is what I have written. How do you write CCF is? So what you got as C, this is 0, this and this will basically cancel. What is CCF is minus 1, Ca will cancel here, minus 1 into. So everybody done. So now can you tabulate this? Let's say all these answers in a table for a PFR, for a CSTR. What is CBF? What is CCF? PFR, what is CBF is 17.5. What is CCF is 18.5. For CSTR, what is CBF is? Go back and see what is the answers here. Six and 30. Now, for maximum B, which reactor you will select? PFR, no? You will select a PFR. Suppose if you select a CSTR, you will form maximum C. For maximum C, you will select a CSTR. This is what we have discussed in our kinetics also. No? A gives P, A gives C. This is 0.1 CA square. This is 2 CA. So, 0.1 CA square. You want maximum here. Then you should select a PFR. You want maximum here, you should select a CST. PFR, which is proved with respect to numbers here. Just take 2 minutes time and read the entire whatever we have discussed till now. Just take 2 minutes time and read the entire quantitative analysis of PFR. So now if you tabulate all the tables, suppose CBF, if I want maximum CBF, if you see CSTR is forming 6, PFR is forming 17.5. So if you want CBF maximum, you should go for a CSTR. CCF, if you see PFR is forming 18.5, CSTR is forming 30. So you should go for a CST, which is what is in line with your qualitative analysis. Qualitative analysis is, suppose if you want maximum B, you go for a PFR. Maximum C, you go for a CSTR. That is what proved with respect to numbers. Now we'll go to another problem. P gives R, S, T. Rate equations 1, 2, CA, CA square. CA naught is equal to 2 mole per liter. Later. So first question is find CSF and tau for a conversion of 0.9 in CSTR. Second question is all will remain same for a conversion of 0.9 in a PFR. So can you solve this problem? So take time, I'm going to give, let's say, 5 to 5 minutes. CSF and tau. Tau is the residence time. Rate expression for R is 1, for S is 2CA, for T is CA square. Write the problems also in your notes. Units of rate will be same, no? It is independent. Mole per liter per minute or something like that. You don't need the units of rate now here. So what is CSF is 0.5. CSTR is 0.5, tau is 1.25. Yes. If you have rate units, then they are still hard to copy. Since I am. Now for CSTR. So for CSTR, how do you solve? Is CSF minus CS naught divided equal to CA naught minus CF equal to 5SF. That means what is 5SF is 2CF by 1 plus 2CF plus CF square. So what is CS naught is 0, CSF. What is CA naught minus CF is? CA naught is 2. What is CF is 0.2. What is CF is 2 into 1 minus 0.2. Remember all these things we are doing it for a liquid phase reactions. Because I am using the equation directly. 2 into 0.2 plus 2.2 square. What is CSF is 0.5 from here. Now how do you calculate tau? Tau is equal to CA naught minus CF divided by minus RA. What is CA naught minus CF divided by what is minus RA? 1 plus 2CF plus CF square. So this is 2 minus 0.2 divided by 1 plus 2 into 0.2 plus 0.2 square. This is what is tau. Now, how do you do it for a PFR? PFR is CSF minus CS naught divided by CA naught minus CF is equal to minus 1 by CA naught minus CF into CA naught to CF into DCA. This and this will cancel. What is CSF minus CS naught is equal to? CS naught is also 0, no? It is 0. What is CSF is? Minus 1 into 2 to 0.2. 2CA by 1 plus CA whole square DCA. How do you solve this integral? This plus 2 minus 2. then what happens? Minus 2 equal to integral 2 to 0.2. This will become 2 by 1 plus CA minus 2 by 1 plus CA whole square into DCA. So what is the integral here is minus of 2 into ln 1 plus CA minus 2, 1 by x square integration is minus 1 by x square integration is minus 1 by x. So which is 1 by CA with the limits of 2 to 0.2, which is what is CSF. So what is the answer for CSF for PFR? 0.83. Now how do you calculate tau? Tau is equal to minus CA naught to CAF DCA by minus RA. This is what is for liquid phase reaction. So all this entire third chapter quantitative analysis is assuming that it is a liquid phase reaction. Minus 2 to 0.2 DCA by what is minus RA? 1 plus 2 CA plus CA square. Somebody is asking why you are adding all the rates, because the one is first one is rate of B formation, rate of C formation, rate of R formation, rate of S formation, rate of let's say T formation. What is our rate of A conversion is all the rate of formations. Clear? So minus tau equal to solve this integral. 2 to 0.2 DCA by 1 plus CA whole square. So what is tau? 0.5 minutes. Next problem. Same. With the same information, PQ S T. This is 1, 2 CA CA square. So now what is the question is same rate expressions CA not equal to two mole per liter. Find maximum expected CS in a CSTR. Second question, find maximum expected CS in a PFR. First thing is just write this question and understand what is different between the previous question and this question. What is difference between previous question and this question? How is it different? What you need to calculate here is maximum CS. What is CS max in CSTR? What is CS max in PFR? What is conversion here? What is the previous question? I have given the conversion. For a given conversion, you need to find out what is CS, what is CS. Here, you need to find out maximum. Then what is the conversion? Is it 100%? Or you will have an optimum value that you need to find out by optimization. Just first start writing the CSF values. Start writing what is expression CSF. Somebody is asking what is conversion of P. If I give conversion of P, then there is no difference between the previous question and this question, no? Somebody is asking for the previous port, so I just displayed previous port. So how do you solve CS theory? CSF minus CS naught CSF minus CS naught divided by CA naught into CF, which is equal to 2CAF by 1 plus 2CF plus CF square. This is 0. What is CAF is 2CAF divided by 1 plus 2CF plus CF square CA naught minus CAF. This is the equation. Now what is here? Your CSF is a function of CF. In the previous question, I have given CF as 0.2, so you have substituted CF. But here CF is the variable. So what you should do is, you should differentiate dCF as CF, which is equal to 0. You will find what is CF optimum. Fine. Then substitute back into CSF here. Then you will find CSF maximum. So the curve might be something like this for CSTR. So if you plot CSF, maybe you start CA naught here. So something like this. So you will have some optimum. So this optimum we need to find. Finally, it becomes zero. This is how the CA naught, this is zero. When CF becomes zero, CSF also becomes zero. What is CF optimum that you are getting after differentiation? CSF maximum is 0.5, but what is CF optimum that you are getting? If you differentiate this one, you will get CAF optimum. That you have to substitute back. You will get CSF maximum. 1 by 3. What is CAF optimum that you will get is here 0.5. What is CSF maximum that you will get is 2/3. Once you substitute CAF 0.5 here, you will get 2/3. The answer that he is asked is this one. You should not stop here. This is only this point. This is 0.5. What is this point is 2/3. So I am not going to do this differentiation. So please do it as, if you have not solved it, please do it as part of, let's say, homework. We'll go to PFR. PFR. So how do you do PFR is CSF minus CS naught is CA naught minus CAF is equal to minus 1 by CA naught minus CAF, CA naught to CAF, 2CA by 1 plus 2C, R2CA plus CA square. Or let's say simply minus RA into DC. So this all will cancel. This is zero. What is CSF is? So I'm reversing the integral. Or let's say you can give as this. CA naught to CAF 2CA. What is minus RA? 1 plus 2CA plus CA square. 1 plus CA whole square DC. Now how do you maximize this number? How to maximize this number? One way, this is 2. You can expand this integral and put CAF and then differentiate and then solve it. That is one way of solving this problem. What is the meaning of, let's say, if I have, let's say, curve of, let's say, 5 to 2 y into dx. Then what is this integral value is nothing but, if I have integral value something like this, this is minus y, this is x, this is let's say what is 5, this is let's say what is 2. What is this integral is nothing but area under this curve, area with the limits of 5 to 2. Is it right or wrong? So what is the meaning of integral is, if you plot y versus x, then from the limits 5 to 2, if this is let's say the curve, then area under this curve is the A sum or area under the curve. Now, suppose if I want to, what is my maximum area under the curve is, then I'll see how max it can go. 5, how, what is the maximum value of bottom and what is the lowest value of this one, or let's say, sorry, this limits is changing. This is 2, this is 5. Then what we start is, what is the maximum value of upper limit? What is the lowest value of upper limit? Let's say lowest value of upper limit can be, let's say, this can go up to 0. This 5 cannot go, or this 5 can go up to, let's say, 8. Then what is my maximum value is? Then u plot at 8, u plot at let's say 0, then what is the area of this curve? Is nothing but let's say the maximum area under the curve. So maximum area under the curve is maximization of integrals. This 2 can go to maximum value is 0, this is minimum value, and this is maximum value, which is 8. So which is y into dx. This is how integral maximization is nothing but maximization of the limits. Now just understand this slide. We'll go back to the previous slide. So now if you go back to the previous one, what is the maximum value, or let's say I'll change the limits, then this is CF to 2 CA by 1 plus I'll use the same color, so I'll interchange the limits CF, or let's say even without interchanging also. What is the highest value of 2? CA not highest value is 2. What is CAF lowest value? So basically, what is difference between, let's say, the CA not, CAF and CA not? So the CA not highest value is 2. What is CAF lowest value? 0. So what is CSF maximum is nothing but minus 2 to 0. Can this 2 go beyond 2? No. Can this 0 go beyond 0? No. Because that 0 is also possible at 100% conversion into DCA. So this is the maximization. Suppose if you are not understood this concept, you can simply apply your integration here. You can apply simply your integration here. Apply the integration over this one. Just to solve this integral. Substitute CAF as it is. Then differentiate. Then you will get your CSF as a function of CAF. Then differentiate, then you will get the same answer. CAF optimum is 0. So just solve this integral, you will get what is the optimum value of CSF or CSF maximum. When we say CAF is 0, conversion is 100%. In CSTR, you don't have this integral concept, no? Why am I maximizing this integral? Because this is an integral. That is why I used this maximization concept. CSTR, PFR, there is no curve because it is keep on increasing as you go on increasing the conversion. There is no optimum here. Optimum will be when the conversion is 100%. Somebody is asking, is it CF0 applicable for all PFRs to get max? It is not for maximum conversion, it is for maximum CSF. Yes, for all maximization of the products. I think we'll stop. If we solve this one, we'll stop here. And we'll open for doubts. Somebody is asking why CF is 0, CA0 is 2. CA0 is 2, no. CF is 0 because... So you have to stretch the limits maximum. That is where I'm stretching the limits. Upper limit is, or let's say, what is the maximum interval of the limits is 0 to 2. There is no other maximum, no? So we'll take the doubts. So from tomorrow onwards, class timing is same or not? So let's see if there is a possibility, I'll start the class from 6 itself. If there is no possibility, I'll start from 6:30. It depends on the times. But in between these two only, 6 or 6:30. So for early starting, I got some concerns from the people that you have the online classes. Class is over. So my email ID I have given, I think, multiple times. It is iswarravm136@gmail.com. I got many mails to send M. Subbu. I'll soon reply to them. Somebody's doubt is, sir, the optimum could be in between 0 to 1 conversion. No, it cannot be. Because for integral, the optimum will be keep on increasing. So 3:30 to 5:30 is also somebody is saying not possible. That is why. How many days is left for completion of the subject? I need 2 more classes for completion of, let's say, chapter 3. So chapter 2, chapter 3, we have done, let's say, quantitative analysis for parallel reactions. I need 1 more class for quantitative analysis for, let's say, series reactions, then 1 more class for, let's say, some of the problems in chapter 3. Then chapter 3 will be, CRE1 will be completed. Then I will take 1 session for problems on CRE1 again, 1 or 2 sections. Then I will start CRE2. So basically it will be, I think we have completed 8 sessions till now. So maybe 10-12 sessions will be remaining, half. I'm going little slowly because there are multiple second year students are there. Will you teach mass transfer? No, I will not teach mass transfer. I did not understood the maximization concept. So that is what I'm saying. What is maximization here is, so here, for CSTR or PFR, maybe for PFRs, just listen this concept. For 2 to 5, this is my area under this curve. Suppose if I want to find out maximum area, I'll stretch this limit this side. So that is what I have done here also. For maximization, what is the maximum value of the CA0 is 2. What is the minimum value of CA0 is 2? 0. So can you put any integral max, or let's say, can you put... This 0 cannot be, it cannot go below 0, it cannot go above 2. So the maximum interval of the is 0 to 2. The maximum concentration interval, or the maximum integral interval is 0 to 2. So that is where your maximum integral remains. So any doubts? So 4 to 6 also some, I am getting the questions because somebody has a question. But let's continue for 2-3 sessions like this, 6 to 8. Maybe later on we'll explore early classes maybe. CA optimum 0.5, it is just a differentiation. No? You have to do differentiation and then find out CA. You need to understand how to differentiate. Yield curve will not be there. This is whatever we have plotted is nothing but an yield curve. What is CSF versus CA? Any other doubts? Yeah, somebody saying 6 by 6:30 to 8:30 is best time. Let's continue. Let's see, somebody is requesting for 4 to 6, 3 to 5 or 6:30. Let's continue this for some time and later on we'll see. Please ask technical doubts, all this next other things will be. Dam color number will not come here. Dam color number is different. So somebody's doubt is in CSTR we are considering xi equal to 0.9, but in PFR we are considering. Who told that we are considering xi equal to 0.9? I am not considering xi equal to 0.9, no. So I have done a differentiation CSTR. I got CAF as 0.5. That means 75% conversion. Why S formed is more in PFR than CSTR? Because it is first order reaction. CSF max, somebody is getting 1.53. So maybe some mistake here. Just check. So any other doubts? Any other doubts? Any other doubts? Please send your doubts, any doubts. Till what time you have classes in your, let's say, course or let's say online classes for your college? Okay, then we'll, if there is no doubts, then we'll close. In PFR, residence time is low. It's not like that in PFR.